Hi there, I'm Kim from the East Sussex Careers Hub, and today, as part of Digital Open Doors, we are going to be visiting Hailsham Roadways. We are being taken around this working site by Victoria, who is Head of Operations at Hailsham Roadways. As this is a working yard, it can be a little bit loud, so I will explain what Victoria is saying here. She is describing that these are concrete lorries, which are like a mini concrete factory on wheels. Concrete is then mixed on the client site, meaning it's fresh. With sand and cement being mixed, the delivery is just as much as the client needs. These lorries are regularly checked, audited, and calibrated. Calibration means we know exactly the weight of each material in the lorry to make, to create the right mix that the client is asking for. Next, we'll meet Shaun, who is one of the drivers of these lorries.
So basically it's a plant on wheels, and we go out to site and do the fresh concrete. Could be a farm, school, someone's house in their back garden. We get it tested once a month by doing cubes. We send them off and they get crushed to see if concrete's to strength. We also do Lego blocks with the concrete, so they interlock and you can make walls with. Concrete is made of four things. It's sharp sand, PB stone, cement and water. When mixed together, it makes concrete. If you don't measure right, concrete will crack and fail, and then someone's house will be built on the concrete and it will crack and fall down. It's very, very important to get the mix correctly right.
This is very exciting. And you may think that we're standing in a pile of mud, but this is actually very environmentally friendly mud. So, construction is happening everywhere around the country, around the world, and we're building things, we're destroying things, we're building things again. But the question is, what do we do with the things that were destroyed? Yeah? This is what. This is all construction material from the roads that are being taken off, from the houses that were destroyed. We have bricks in here, we have some road materials, we have some what is underneath the road, yes? And then normally it would have been going into the landfill, which is really not good for the environment. But what we do with it, we crush it with a certain radius and it becomes this, which is, we call it certified type 1. It's going under the road asphalt as a foundation of the road. So meaning that this becomes something useful again, and we can reuse it. Same with asphalt, or you may know that as a tarmac, yes? When you resurface some road, you need to take that asphalt off. And what you do with it? You crush it back. Yes, you make it smaller pieces again out of big bolts that are coming out of asphalt. You crush it and then you put it back into the plant, recycling plant that we have over there, together with the type 1 that I just spoke about, and it's becoming new asphalt, new road materials. How cool is that? As environmental friendly, we're reusing everything that was used before, yes? Yeah, but what is important about this is a science behind it. You need to have a correct proportions of type 1, of crushed asphalt, of special bitumens that are added, or cement or limestone or alternatives. So you need to understand chemistry behind it, how limestone is reacting with asphalt, how cement is reacting with bitumens, yes? If you don't understand that, the new road will not gonna hold, and you have a pothole in no time again. So it's very important to understand chemistry, it's very important to understand mass in correct proportions, and very important to check that nothing got out of the line. Alright?
Hailsham Roadways pride themselves on their more environmentally friendly asphalt. Here we can see the digger digging up crushed tarmac that has already been used on the roads. Then they load it into the plant and this will create new material for the road. This process uses 40% less carbon dioxide than traditional methods, which will heat all of the products at around 180 degrees, Instead, Hailsham Roadways use a cold process, saving carbon dioxide.
So, why do materials stick? Yeah? Look, if we take a handful of shingle, yes, and try to stick them together, they don't stick, do they? No, no. Yeah? And this is because they have no fines, no very fine elements in this in my hand, yeah? However, look, if I do take a shingle and then I add the correct amount of sand together, and hopefully if I would add water, yes? Look, it stays together, it sticks. It didn't stick properly because there's no cement and no other fines, yeah? But it sticks much better than just a shingle, isn't it? That's why, this is the science behind, that's why it's important when you think of construction materials to add the correct proportions of different gradings, different diameter materials, so they bond and stick together very well. They hold each other.
Here we see the beginning of the asphalt being created after all the materials have been mixed together. Roles in construction companies aren't just outside working. There are many office roles that make a successful business. Also, yes, it was Halloween when I visited Hailsham Roadways.
I sell concrete to customers and aggregates to customers. I'm also dealing with all the men in the stores, dishing out their plant and equipment in the morning and all their protective clothing. And various other bits at the moment, and I'm still dealing with some of the accounts, the subcontractors, and I also deal with the payroll.
Thank you. That's great. And whereabouts would we be going to? Oh, fine. It's nice and local. That's great. Yeah. Okay. No, that's absolutely fine. Okay, I'll get Beth to call you. Then she can run through everything that we've got and what we can supply. I've got concrete. We do type one, so recycled, and the, you know, the proper MOT pink type one. So I'll get her to give you a call, okay? So that involves organising plant materials, resource for all the jobs that we have. So not only on the day, but looking ahead at what we're going to need in a few weeks' time, months' time, and making any changes as necessary during the day or going forward. So. Okay. Can be very straightforward and very normal. If everything goes to plan, it's a very straightforward job, but the biggest hurdle is probably organising last minute changes. So if people call in sick overnight, rearranging the gang structure, if a vehicle breaks down, we have to work out how we get a delivery picked up or anything sorted out instead. If it rains, like today, jobs get postponed or cancelled, so they have to be rescheduled. A tarmac plant might break down, so we then have to work out how we get a tarmac sorted out. And just the daily phone calls and things that, you know, change every day. So really, the most challenging thing is dealing with the changes that happen that aren't planned. So the unforeseen, I suppose. It's a great company to work for. So yeah, good company, good people, very supportive.
That's my name is Victoria, and I'm one of the shareholders of Hailsham Roadways, and also head of operations at Hailsham Roadways. I worked in 5 countries, different countries of the world. I worked in 3 different continents, from America to Europe to Middle East. Then back into this island, beautiful island. I had a variety of jobs in different industries. I worked in the agriculture industry, in insurance industry, and hospitals, and as well now in construction industry. Construction industry is a very challenging industry, but at the same time, very, very interesting industry. And it's an industry that is going through a massive change at the moment. So industry that is getting really digitalized is getting innovative. Yeah. So everything that we had in any other industries 10, 15 years ago, now it's coming into construction. It's a time, it's that exciting time of change. It's also very interesting from the different angle. It's actually construction is something that you build and you can see a final result. While in some other industries, you can spend a lot of time crunching data, looking at some operational changes, but actually there is no physical result that you can be proud of, that you can take a picture and put on your social media that I did it. Where in construction industry, if you're resurfacing road nice and finally you can be proud and you drive on that road and your grandma drives on that road, said, I did it, I'm proud, it looks good and it's long lasting, yes? If you build a house, you can say, I did these houses, I built them, they're there, it's my job. So it's something that you can really touch and be proud of. The industry is really, really welcoming women, and this is the beauty again of the industry, that is really open-minded and inviting women, an industry that wants to be more diverse, because of course naturally it's a man-driven industry. It was like this for many, many years, but every company is inviting women now because they understand, companies understand the value of diversity. So it's not only women, as we talk about representatives from different sexual orientations, from different skin color, and all of this diversity is really, really valued. So it's great. It's great to be a woman in the construction industry. It's many, many skills that are very important in my job. I would say the key is to be able to listen and to hear what people say. As a head of operations, my job is to ensure that jobs are delivered in time, in quality, but the most important thing, in a safe manner. I can only deliver and help guys to deliver jobs in a safe manner if I listen to them and hear what problems they have on site, what unsafe situations they have on site, yes? Same with quality. If I understand why they cannot do quality job, what stops them from doing quality job, maybe it's the wrong equipment they have, maybe they're not skilled enough, yes? Maybe they need additional training, yes? Maybe the structure of the team is not correct. So that listening and hearing and taking actions is very important. Organizational skills are very important as well, because we have nearly 100 people and now they do very different roles. They all have very different characters, they all have very different skills and training, yes? So to organize them in the correct way, to organize my time and prioritize my time, so I have time for most important issues, is very important, yeah? And then it comes computer skills, then it comes math skills, then it comes science skills to understand the science behind construction, why some materials last long, why some materials are not good to use in certain time of the year. So that's all of that. It's very important. And I think another thing that I want to point is curiosity. To be curious in life takes you everywhere, yes? If you're curious and you start understanding things and you start experimenting and innovating and do something different that has been done for many years, yes? This curiosity took me all around the world. I worked in a fantastic, many fantastic organizations, met hundreds of interesting people. Yes, my network helps me today when I have questions or I have challenges in my career, in my professional path or personal. And this is due to curiosity and taking opportunities, yes, that provided to you. The key tip would be just go for it. When you're young, you can achieve whatever you want. Just go for it. Grab opportunities and try. And with your first job, if you get to some organization, for example, like Hailsham Roadways, we have over 50 different roles in here you can try, yes? From lorry driver to laborer to skilled foreman to estimator in the office to operations to health and safety, personnel, payroll, accounts, finance, you name it, everything is there. So get your first job, get your work experience, start with work experience, and see where your heart is. And your first job may not gonna be your last job, and that's fine, yes? You will go through different careers, different jobs, different organizations, but stick with one organization for a lengthy time, for at least a year or two, so you understand how an entire organization works and you know exactly which way you wanna go next.
Thank you to Hailsham Roadways for welcoming in Open Doors. If you would like to learn more about them, please check out their website or ask the Open Doors team for the relevant lesson plan. Thanks for watching, and I will see you at the next Digital Open Doors video. Bye!